where do I start? These vaccines, though. So I was gonna use this tinfoil to make a tinfoil hat to make some kind of funny intro, but then I realized there aren't any black people on the internet wearing a tinfoil hat, and I don't want to be the first. I can talk about vaccines. It's not a big deal, right? I'm good. You good? I'm saying I'm good if you good. You good? Okay, intro. How y'all feeling? My name is Johnny. This is No Lab Coat Required, and this exists because the stuff that makes us healthier should not be confusing false or exclusively for people in lab coats. And Merry Christmas, them Rona shots is here. From what I see, everyone is falling into one of two camps. Get that needle away from me. I don't want anything to do with it. Y'all made that too damn fast. Others are saying, give me that. I need it. Sick of the BS. Give me the shot. There is no right or wrong opinion about the shot, but I'll tell you one thing. I haven't met one person that's sad that the pandemic is soon to be over. It's soon to be over, right? Vaccines here. What does it do? How is it different? Is the pandemic over? And who the heck is Pfizer? As a researcher, I like information. The more informed we are, the better we are off. And I think this pandemic has opened the floodgates for misinformation, my sworn enemy. Virology is complex, and when something has so many layers, it leaves hella space for the input of misinformation. At the same time, I think a lot of people, including myself, has learned a lot more about the immune system and virology. Anyways, what does the vaccine do? Let's start by understanding what it doesn't do. Unfortunately, this is not the Iron Legend cure to the apocalypse.
I can save everybody!
It doesn't cure corona. The goal of the vaccine is to prime our also powerful immune system to be better at fighting the virus in case we get it sometime in the future. To paint the picture, the vaccine is basically a secret intelligence agent that tells our immune system the lowdown. This is a picture of your enemy. These are his go-to fighting moves, and this is what he likes to do in his spare time. The vaccine is giving our immune system the information it needs so that it can better defend and fight in case we get the virus instead of getting caught by surprise. Now, what makes the COVID vaccine different? Two things. First off, we made this joint fast as hell.
All right, this is it, people. Let's move. Let's go, 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 go.
Operation Warp Speed? Operation Warp Speed, bro? So if there's any confusion about if this vaccine was rushed, it was. I mean, it's not like we were about to take our time. Historically, we've made vaccines from dead or weakened versions of viruses known as inactive viruses or live attenuated viruses. So we take this virus, beat it up, throw it in a vaccine, give it to our immune system, and now our immune system is better equipped to fight that virus. The COVID vaccine, though, it's built different.
We built different, dog. We built different.
The COVID vaccine doesn't use an inactive version of a virus, but instead a little piece of the virus, specifically called the S protein. However, the S protein isn't what's in the shot. In order for us to understand how this works, we have to know exactly what protein is. Proteins are the tools our cells use to do stuff. Our cells have many, many jobs, and in order to do those jobs, they use protein, which is their screwdriver, their drill, their hammer, whatever it needs to be. The function of a protein, whether it's a screwdriver, drill, or hammer, is dependent upon its shape. So the shape of a protein literally determines its function. So with this information, you get a bunch of lab coat wearers that get together and make the exact shape of the S protein, which basically mimics the coronavirus. But like I said, this isn't what is put into the shot. Depending on the company that made the shot could determine which of two things we can get, DNA or mRNA of the S protein. So let's bring it full circle. If proteins are the tools of the body, they help the cells do things, then the DNA is the blueprint. It has the information of how to make the proteins needed to do things. mRNA is the worker, it's the middleman. It knows what the cell has to do, and it learned from the DNA how to make the necessary protein. It basically read the blueprint, said, this is the protein we have to make, and it helps make that protein. So if or when you get a shot, you are either getting the DNA or the mRNA of the S protein. But because the S protein of the coronavirus is not of our body, then we're going to trigger the immune response that we're looking for.
Identify yourself, who the are you?
Using this version of the vaccine instead of the inactive virus that we traditionally used in the past is evidently easier and cheaper, which explains how we made it so fast. There are still unanswered questions. For example, we don't know how long this vaccine lasts, and we don't know if it could prevent further transmission of the disease. This is important to figure out because the pandemic is based on the number of cases. Historically, pandemics have ended when reported cases are few and far in between. So like I said, the vaccine isn't the cure for corona, but logically speaking, it's the cure for the pandemic. There are tons of companies working on a COVID vaccine. However, we keep hearing of Pfizer and Moderna. We keep hearing of these companies because they are the front runners of this new vaccine technology. In further months and years, other and different versions of the vaccine will be released by different companies. I want to say this last thing and I'll be out your way. If you ever tested positive for COVID, know that your immune system has already been exposed to the virus and responded better than any vaccine could make it respond. Theoretically, the vaccine would do the most justice for those who are more susceptible to severe complications of COVID. We know that 94% of people who've passed from COVID had an average of 3 other comorbidities. The vaccine is here, but perhaps it's time to start talking about healthier life. With that being said, give this joint a like if you got some value out of it. You can find me, No Lab Coat Required, on YouTube and Instagram, and I'm gonna get up out your way. Prediction is that we'll have masks and 6 feet mandates lifted in the first week of January. Bet money, don't at me.